Hi guys, today we're making these cute little piggies. There is also a free written pattern if you don't want to watch a video. You don't have to. You can print off this pattern on my blog. You can find the link to the pattern in the description box below. This video follows along this entire pattern. For these piggies, I'm using a size 4mm hook, and I'm also using worsted weight yarn. This is Red Heart Comfort Yarn. You'll find the color code in the pattern. Feel free to use any hook size and yarn weight you'd like to. But to get the piggies this size, then use what I'm using. So with all that said, let's get started. Before we start crocheting the head and the body, we're going to make that little snout first because we're going to sew this on before we stuff the head. So the snout is just one little tiny piece. Row one is a loop with 6 stitches. So to get that loop with 6 stitches, you can do it two ways. You can use the magic ring method, which is my favorite, or you can chain two and work 6 stitches into the second chain from the hook. Now I have tutorials that will walk you through both those methods here on YouTube, and you'll find those links in the description box below. So I'll go quickly over the magic loop with you now, and then you can decide if that method works for you or not. So I'm going to take the tail end of the yarn, I'm going to wrap it around these two fingers twice. Then I'm going to hold the tail end of the yarn between my pinky and my thumb, and then hold the working yarn in between my pinky and my thumb. I'm going to go through those two loops. I'm going to grab the yarn back here, and I'm going to pull it through those two loops. Now I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through that little loop I just made. And there's my slip knot. Now I can take the piece off my fingers and get ready to crochet on. Now I'm going to put 6 stitches into this ring. I'm going to put my hook through the middle of both those loops. Through the middle, grab the yarn, pull it through. Yarn over and pull through. And there was 1 single crochet in that loop. I'm going to repeat that 5 more times. Going through the middle, grab the yarn, pull it through. Yarn over, pull through. And there was 2, 3, 4. 5, and last time, 6. And there's my 6 single crochets into my magic ring. I'm going to pull this yarn tail out of those strings to get it out of the way. I'm going to hold the end of this string of crochets between my finger and my thumb. And I'm going to pull on one of these two strings. I'm going to pull upwards from here to close up this ring. That one didn't work, so I know it's the other one. I'm pulling upward, and there I've closed my ring. Now I'm going to take the yarn tail and pull on it to get rid of that string. And there's my loop with 6 stitches. So this knot is done. Now all we have to do is slip stitch into the first stitch that we made. So we're just going to go across there, going through both loops of that stitch, grab the yarn, pull it through. Now we're going to pull the first loop through the second loop. And that completes the snout. Now we're just going to finish off. So pull out your last stitch so you don't lose it. And break free. Leave a little bit of yarn that you can sew into the head with. Pull that yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. And then you want to stretch out the piece so it's nice and flat. And if this hole here is very visible, we can close it up just by pulling on this yarn tail. Hold on to your piece and then pull the yarn tail. And that closed up the hole in the middle. So now we can set that aside and we'll start working on the pig's head. Row one is a loop with 6 stitches, and we're starting at the top of the head, and we're going to work all the way down to the bottom of the body. The head and the body are worked in one piece. So to get that loop with 6 stitches, you can do it two ways. You can use the magic ring method, which is my favorite, or you can chain two and work 6 stitches into the second chain from the hook. Now I have tutorials that will walk you through both those methods here on YouTube, and you'll find those links in the description box below. So I'll go quickly over the magic loop with you now, and then you can decide if that method works for you or not. So I'm going to take the tail end of the yarn, I'm going to wrap it around these two fingers twice. Then I'm going to hold the tail end of the yarn between my pinky and my thumb, and then hold the working yarn in between my pinky and my thumb. I'm going to go through those two loops. I'm going to grab the yarn back here, and I'm going to pull it through those two loops. Now I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through that little loop I just made. And there's my slip knot. Now I can take the piece off my fingers and get ready to crochet on. Now I'm going to put 6 stitches into this ring. I'm going to put my hook through the middle of both those loops. Through the middle, grab the yarn, pull it through. Yarn over and pull through. And there was 1 single crochet in that loop. I'm going to repeat that 5 more times. Going through the middle, grab the yarn, pull it through. Yarn over, pull through. And there was 2. 3, 4, 5, and last time, 6. And there's my 6 single crochets into my magic ring. I'm going to pull this yarn tail out of those strings to get it out of the way. I'm going to hold the end of this string of crochets between my finger and my thumb. And I'm going to pull on one of these 2 strings. I'm going to pull upwards from here to close up this ring. That one didn't work, so I know it's the other one. I'm pulling upward. And there, I've closed my ring. Now I'm going to take the yarn tail and pull on it to get rid of that string. And there's my loop with 6 stitches. So when you look at your loop in that center hole, if that's too big, if you think it's too big, you can close it up just by pulling on this yarn tail. So the starting yarn tail, we're going to leave it hanging, and we'll tuck it into the piece as the piece gets bigger. Or if you'd like to get rid of it, you can crochet it into the second row just by holding it along the edge and then crocheting around it. For this tutorial, I'm just going to leave it hanging. So row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. And if you turn it to the side, you can see the stitches there. They look like a V. So the first one, the count is underneath this big loop, and it's that V right there. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the 6th one is right in front of this string here, 6. So you should have 6 V's around. So we'll carry on to row 2, 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So when you go through your first stitch, just make sure that you're going through both loops of the stitch every time you go through. So you want to make sure you have both loops of that stitch on top of your hook. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. And there was 1. Now we're going to go back in the same stitch hole and put our 2nd single crochet. And there was 2. Going into the 2nd stitch now, 1 single crochet. Back in the same stitch, and 2 single crochets. Going on to the 3rd stitch now, 1 single crochet, back in the same hole, 2 single crochets. Into the 4th now, 1 single crochet, and back in, 2 single crochets. Into the 5th now, make sure when you go through you have 2 loops that stitch on top of your hook. 1 single crochet and back in, 2 single crochets. Now the last time for this row, into the 6th stitch, 1 single crochet and 2 single crochets. At any time, if I'm going too fast, just pause the video, catch up, and then press play when you're ready to go again. That's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around, so you should be able to count 12 of those V's. So here I'm going to add a stitch marker, and then I'm going to move that marker every time I finish a row. I'm just going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. Just leave that big loop hanging. I just use a piece of yarn of a different color, and I'm going to go right through my last stitch I just put in. I'm going to grab that marker, just lay it over the hook, and pull it through. I'm just going to pull 1 strand through and leave them hanging on each side, just like that. Now this stitch marker can be pulled out, so it might not work for some of you. There are real stitch markers out there. You decide which works best for you. Row 3 is 1 single crochet in the first stitch, and then two single crochets into the second, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, all the way to the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in two single crochets. One in the first, and two single crochets into the second stitch. 1 and 2, and now repeat that. One single crochet in the first, and two single crochets into the second stitch. And now you just keep repeating that sequence all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I just finished row 3 and I've moved my marker. We now have 18 stitches around. Row 4 is one single crochet in the first two stitches, then two single crochets into the third stitch, and then repeat that. 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one single crochet in the second, and then two single crochets into the third stitch. And now you're just going to keep repeating that all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 4, and I've moved my marker. We now have 24 stitches around. Rows 5 through 8 is one single crochet in each one of those 24 stitches for 4 rows. So what I like to do, instead of counting in my head, is every time I finish a row, and I move that marker, I put a notch on my notepad. So when I have 4 of those notches, I'll know I'm done. So one single crochet in each one of those 24 stitches for 4 rows. Remember to keep track on a notepad, and we'll meet back here when we're finished row 8. Remember to move your marker at the end of every row. Alright, I just finished row 8 and I've moved my marker. So if you lost track on your notepad or you forgot to keep track, you can also count the rows to see where you're at. This is row 1 down here, the middle loop that we started off with. When you count the rows, always count behind your marker. If you count in the front, you might get thrown off by a row, just because it dips down here a little bit. So always count behind the marker, and you just count the rings. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So we know that we're on the 8th row. And also, if the piece was folded up on itself, this is the wrong side, the part where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, and you can see the stitches don't look as neat as they do on the other side. So you just want to make sure that you flip the right way. And this is the right side. Alright, ready to carry on to row 9. This is where we start decreasing, making the hole a bit smaller. So for this row, we're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches, 1, 2, and then we're going to crochet two stitches together. So let's work this row together. One single crochet in the first, one single crochet in the second, and now we're going to crochet two together. The way I decrease, I just go through both stitches, grab the yarn, pull it through. Now I have two loops. Go into the next stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. Now I have three loops. Yarn over and pull through all three loops. And I've just crocheted two together. If you start seeing gaps in your stitches as you're decreasing, I'm going to show you how to fix that. So one single crochet in the first, one single crochet in the second, and then if you're seeing gaps in your decreases, then we're going to do an invisible decrease by working in the front loops only. So just go through that front loop, grab your yarn, pull it through. Go in the next front loop, grab your yarn, pull it through. Now you have three loops, yarn over and pull through all three loops. So you decide which method you want to use. One single crochet in the next two stitches, 1, 2, and then crochet two together. And I don't bother working the front loops because I don't really see gaps in my work. And I think it's mostly because I crochet more on the tight side. But if you see gaps in your work, then remember you can fix that by working in the front loops only. So you just keep repeating that sequence all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So we'll just finish off this row together. And now I'm going to crochet two together, and you can see that second stitch is going to land on the marker, so I'll pull it out and crochet two stitches together. And that finishes row 9, and now we have 18 stitches around. Now we're going to stop and we're going to sew the snout on. So remember to pull out your last stitch so you don't lose it. So just pull it out and leave it hanging in a big loop. So the snout is sewn over the 6th and the 8th row. So we're just going to thread our yarn needle with the first yarn tail. I'm just going to bend the strand over and I'm going to push the bend through the needle. Then I'll place this over the 6th and 8th row. We can just count from up here, the starting ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we know that's the 6th one, 7 and 8th. So I'll just bring this through. And now we'll thread the other yarn tail. And we're going to sew this around. You want to make sure that you're not sewing right along the edge here, because you need to crochet into that. So make sure it stays over the 6th and 8th row, leaving the 9th row free. And this doesn't take much to sew into place. And you'll notice I'm going from back to front, and I'm not whip stitching the edges, because you want them to be kind of sitting off from the head a little bit. And you don't want to sew those edges to the head. You want to leave it kind of like it's popping out from the head, if that makes sense. Sorry. Over-explaining things, I guess, gets a little complicated. So that should do it. I sewed all the way around on the inside and not the outside. Now I can knot off these two yarn tails inside. And if you are using safety eyes, which I am not using, I'll show you in a second. So I'm just going to cut these up a bit shorter and I'll leave that tucked inside the head. So if you're using safety eyes, now is the time to put them in. Those are the eyes with the backs on them and they snap closed. And once you snap them closed, they cannot come off. So you want to make sure that you are happy with the placements before you put the backs on, of course. I'm doing the eyes at the very end after we're done sewing the pig together. So he'll be stuffed and closed and sewn together. Okay, so now we can carry on to row 10. So I'm going to add my marker again. Row 10 is one single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two together. So remember, there's two methods of decreasing. If you're starting to see gaps, then you want to decrease in the front loops only. And if you don't see gaps, then don't worry about it. Just put one single crochet in the first, then crochet two together. One in the first, and if you're seeing gaps, crochet in those front loops. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when you land on the marker. Remember, when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll finish row 10, and now we have 12 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Row 11 is one single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together and repeat all the way around. And when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two together. So as this hole gets smaller, you can see it would be very easy to go back into the last stitches you just crocheted together. So make sure you're not doing that. Make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the row. One in the first and crochet two together. One in the first. A little bit awkward to crochet in these smaller rounds. And then crochet two together. You can see I'm flattening the head out and crocheting into the stitches that way. And then moving it over as I crochet along. one single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together. And last time, one in the first, two together is going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out, and crochet two together. Look how small that hole is now. Now we only have 8 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. So for row 12, we're going to put 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches. So 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. And take your time as you go around. You don't want to be getting frustrated, and take breaks if you need them. I guess I make it look a little bit easy because I can crochet a little bit on the fast side. But remember, I've been doing this for many years now, so it takes practice. And even I make mistakes, like I just did there. Try that again. 2 single crochets into that stitch. And now the last time, I'm going to pull out that marker and put in 2 single crochets. I'll finish row 12, and now we have 16 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. Row 13 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. You're going to repeat that all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. So 1 in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, and 2 single crochets into the fourth. Now repeat that all the way around, and I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 13, and now we have 20 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Row 14, we're going to repeat the last row. 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the fourth stitch, and repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll continue on the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 14, and now we have 25 stitches around. We're going to stop, and we're going to stuff the head now. So I'm going to pull up my last stitch, pull it out quite a ways so you don't lose it. And we're just going to stuff and shape that head. So with acrylic yarn, you can shape the head quite a bit as you're stuffing. So I'm just going to get the majority in there first, just stuffing in lots. You can see it takes lots of stuffing. And now I'm pushing stuffing into the sides of the head with my finger. And getting stuffing all in this area down here. There we go. Now we can add our marker. And get ready to crochet on. So this one, we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then we're going to crochet 2 stitches together. Remember, there's 2 ways to decrease. Use the method that works best for you. I just go right through those stitches, through both loops of the stitches, and crochet 2 of them together. But if you're seeing gaps, then you want to work in the front loops only. That's 1, 2, and 3. And crochet 2 together. And now repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 15. I've moved my marker. We now have 20 stitches around. Row 16, we're going to repeat the last row. 1 single crochet in the next 3, then crochet 2 stitches together. And repeat all the way around. And when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll continue on the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 16, and now we have 16 stitches around. Move my marker. Row 17 is one single crochet in the next two stitches, then crochet two together, repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. Now remember, when this hole gets a bit smaller, it's very easy to go back into those last stitches you crocheted together. So make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the next row. One in the first, one in the second, then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around, and we'll meet back here and we land on the marker. I'll finish row 17, and then we have 12 stitches around, and we're going to finish off. We're going to slip stitch the next stitch and finish off. So go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through. Instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop. Now we'll finish off, and we're going to leave a bit of a tail for closing up that gap. Pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. So now we're going to stuff the body, but before we do that, we're going to weave in and out of those remaining stitches. So just spread your yarn tail. And we're going to weave in and out of these front loops only. So go in the front loop, and then down through the next one. Up through the next front loop, and down through the next one. All the way around. And if you pulled it closed at all, just open it back up. And now we can stuff the body. Stuff in as much as you can. And then if it keeps falling out of there because the gap is too big, you can close up the gap a little bit by pulling on that yarn tail. And then you can push more stuffing in. And if the hole is too small for you to push more in, just use the back end of a pencil. So that should do it there. You can see the body's quite a bit smaller than the head. Cute little guy. Now we can pull that yarn tail to close up the gap. Hang on to it so it doesn't let go. And now you're going to knot off. And pull tight. There we go. Now we can just get rid of this yarn tail. Just pull it through and bring it out anywhere on the body through a stitch hole. Pull on it slightly and cut. So that brings us to the end of part one. I will put the link to part two somewhere up here. And if you don't see it up there, then look in the description box below. And in part two, we'll make the arms and the legs. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you soon.